Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to Cool Puzzles. This is puzzle number 5 and this is titled 100 Coins. Now if you haven't seen this series, I've already posted 4 puzzles before. Go ahead and check the videos in my playlists and you'll be able to find the Cool Puzzle section. And this is puzzle number 5. I sincerely hope that you must have enjoyed the previous puzzles. And I really hope that you will enjoy this one too. And as is the tradition in this particular series, I'm going to explain the puzzle to you. Go ahead and understand the puzzle properly. Replay it if you really want to. And then pause the video and try to solve the puzzle on your own. And after you've exhausted all your attempts, or after having gotten an answer, go ahead and see the answer. Play the video from that point. So first of all, I'm going to give you the answer. And then again, you need to pause the video and try to figure out how is this explanation valid in case it is not matching with yours. And after several attempts or after having understood, go ahead and check the explanations and you should be able to understand this puzzle. So let's go ahead into 100 coins. So the puzzle goes like this. You can see some coins here. There are 10 sets of 10 coins each. Each coin of each set weighs exactly 1 gram, except one set which has all fake coins, and each fake coin weighs 2 grams. So you can see 10 sets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So basically you have 10 sets of 10 coins each. So there are totally 100 coins. Set 1 up to set 10. Each coin of 9 sets weigh 1 gram each, whereas there is one particular set in which each coin weighs 2 grams. So 9 sets have each coin weighing 1 gram, one set has each coin weighing 2 grams. So now let's go ahead and check out what is the question. You are allowed to use an extremely accurate digital weighing machine only once. How will you find which set has all fake coins? So you have a digital weighing machine and you are only allowed to weigh once. You can put as many coins as you want. You can put one or you can put all the 100. But you are only allowed one weighing. And with one weighing, you should be able to figure out of those 10 sets, which one has fake coins. Remember, this is not beam balance. It's a balance which is digital. It will give you exact reading. It will say, okay, 10 grams. It will say 5 grams. It will give you the exact value. So how would you weigh with only one weighing allowed to figure out which set has the fake coins? So at this moment, you should pause. You will see a caption saying pause now. So pause the video. And if you haven't understood the puzzle, go back and see it again. And then ensure that you give proper attempts in solving this puzzle. Remember, this particular series is meant to make you think. Don't immediately come back to see the explanation. Don't be impatient. Remember, you can solve it. If you can understand the solution, it means you could have solved it on your own. All you have to do is practice thinking. Make sure that you get it on your own. Take as much time as you want. In fact, when I was given this puzzle, it took me more than 1 hour to solve it on my own. And I did not look at the answer, though the answer was given. So that is the excitement of solving a puzzle. And after having made several attempts, if you still are not able to get it, then go ahead and see the answer. Or if you might have got it, go ahead and see the answer. And then pause again after seeing the answer. So pause now. Welcome back. I hope you have given sufficient effort in trying to solve this particular puzzle, or you might have even got the answer. So here is the answer. The answer is 1. We will take 1 coin from set 1, 2 from set 2, 3 from set 3, and so on. So to weigh it, what we will do, we will distribute them into sets. We will number each set as 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. We will take 1 coin from set 1, 2 from set 2, 3 from set 3, 4 from set 4, and likewise 10 from set 10. Put all of them into the weighing machine. It'll give you a reading. Using that reading, you can actually figure out which set has the fake coins, the ones which weigh 2 grams each. Now, this is the answer. Now, I want you to go back and figure out why is this the answer in case you are not able to get the answer. And if your answer matches, go ahead and see the explanation just to check whether your explanation and mine do match or not. So again, pause now, and in case you haven't got the answer or you didn't get the right answer, go ahead and think about why is your answer not right and why is this answer going to work. Pause now. Welcome back again. So let's see the explanation. Why is this? This is because if I take, let's say the first set is fake coins. So every other set will have coins of 1 gram each. So the weight would be 2 grams from set 2, 3 grams from set 3. So 2 to 10, you keep adding all the numbers. 2 plus 3 plus 4, because each coin weighs 1 gram in the other sets. So from the second set, since you lifted 2 coins, it should weigh 2 grams. 3 from set 3 should weigh 3 grams. So 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 up to 10. Now from set 1, you've taken only 1 coin. And that will weigh 2 grams. And finally add 2 to this number. You will get some particular value. Now assume it was not the first set, the second set was fake. So the first set you took 1 coin, it should weigh 1 gram. Third set, you took 3 coins, it should weigh 3 gram. So now add 1 plus 3 plus 4 up to 10. And then in set 2, you took 2 coins, each weighing 2 gram, that will weigh 4 grams. Now add it to this value. You will find a unique answer. The first answer will be different from the second answer. If the third were fake coins, you will get a different answer. So for each set having fake coins, the total mass value that you will get would be different. In fact, you will see by the calculation, it will keep increasing by 1 depending on which set it is. So you pre-calculate all of this. Assume that first set is fake, assume second is fake, assume third is fake. You get answers for each of them. You calculate those answers. Then go ahead and weigh it. And in whichever value it matches, you know which set is fake. Let's go ahead and see those values. This way, we will get a unique answer for the weight depending upon which set has all coins fake. The very act of taking 1 gram from 2 from 2, we are taking different amount from different sets. If I had taken 1 coin from each set, it would not have resulted in any way of me finding out which set has fake coins, because irrespective of whether 1 has fake or 2 has fake, the total mass will be the same. But by taking different number of coins from each set, we have made the answer unique for each set to be having a fake coin. Let's see the calculations now. And the calculation goes like this. Set which has all coins fake. Let's say first set has all coin fake. If you calculate the total value, it will weigh 56 grams. If instead of first, the second was fake, it will weigh 57 grams. Instead of second, if you had third, 58 grams. The reason is, here, this first set, the coin is going to weigh 2 grams. So this value is based on that. Now, if this is not fake, but this is fake, so this 2 gram will become 1 gram. Right? So the mass will first decrease by 1. Secondly, from here I've taken 2 coins. Initially, for this value, to get this value, we had assumed this to be 2 grams. But now it is 4 grams. So from 4, I deduct 2, which was already here. And then I deduct 1, because this is not fake anymore. So I deduct 3 from 4, so it increases by 1. I hope you understood this. What I'm saying is, first set was fake. Let's assume that. So I took 1 coin from that. It weighs 2 grams. From the second set, I took 2 coins and they weighed 2 grams. And with this logic, the mass was 56 grams. First set was 2 grams, second set was 4 grams. Now, if the second were fake, the first set will be 1 gram only. And the second set will be 4 gram now. So initially, it was 2 gram from set 1, 2 from set 2, because each was weighing 1 gram in second set. So what is the total value? 4. And now it is 1 gram in set 1 and 4 in set 2. How much is it? 5. So initially it was 4, now it is 5. That means now the total and all other sets are the same. From 3 to 10 all are non-fake because second is fake in the second option. So therefore the total value will increase by 1. Now it is 1 plus 4, 5. Initially it was 2 plus 2, 4. So likewise, what will happen is, depending upon which set is having fake coins, you will find the mass always increasing by 1 gram. But that is not the point that it is increasing by 1 gram. The point is, for each set to be fake, I get a unique answer. So if suppose, let's say, I suddenly get the mass of 62 grams, I know 7th set is fake. If I get the mass of 59 grams, I know 4th set is fake. So this way, I will be able to identify the fake set with a single weighing. So that is the end of this puzzle. And I hope you enjoyed solving this puzzle. And if there are any comments, any suggestions, any new puzzles that you have, you want me to solve in this series, please drop them in the comment section below. This is Kalyan Kumar. Have a great day. Goodbye. And thank you for watching. If you found the videos of this channel interesting and useful, and you haven't subscribed to this channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button just below the video. The moment you subscribe, you'll find a bell icon. Click this. In this, you'll allow YouTube to send you all notifications of this channel. Make sure that you check this box and you save. Now you are subscribed to this channel and you will receive all notifications from this channel the moment any video is posted. And if you like the video, go ahead and hit the like button.